Hi guys, everyone today. Can you please tell me if you hear me good and if you see the webcam? I will also put your 25. Hi Maggie, perfect. Okay, I will wait one more minute and then I will start the session. Little Heineck, happy to see you. You attend maybe almost all the trading room, so that's nice. I hope you liked the content. Hi, Conrad. Okay, let's start. Little disclaimer before, put the chat on all panelists and attendees, then you can discuss together about the market and about the chart and what I'm talking about. The second thing is all the trade I will take or the analysis I will do. It's something for, it's my own view. So still stick with the plan, stick with risk management. Everyone has his own strategy. I will try to make something very global and what is about the market. And maybe I also like to make some scalping trade to make the trading the room interactive. So I hope it will be helpful. So if there is, I love starting by analyzing your pair that you guys in the chat want to review. So if you have a pair or an open position that you want to discuss, you can put the pairs you want on the chat. Okay. Hi, Gerard. Hi. Okay, just a little thing before the so we see that the bundle have break this kind of a strong support last week, I think. So it was a downing of approximately 250 pips. Then the price recover exactly to this zone. Again, this zone is the zone that was a support, then became a resistance, and we're starting to struggle passing over this this kind of zone. Okay, and if I go to the H4, it's kind of the same. So approximately the zone in green is the zone is the support zone that became actually a resistance, and we make a small retest. Actually, I think we can see also in the H1, we made a first test here, approximately to the zone, make a small retracement, then we push it above, and then see the price went down to so actually the price can have a lower move. Okay, actually we see that here the price all the time make an higher low. Okay, so we have this low, then here, and all the time the price was in ILO, and when the price drop actually this kind of zone, okay, to that point, and reach this level, so actually we are in a bearish scenario or in a downtrend. Okay, so you have to be careful. Maybe the price can make another touch, okay, to that rectangle. There is also a supply on the H1 that can be interesting to look. Okay, it will be this zone here on the H1. Okay, so it will be this supply. And also, it's also a nice zone actually here to enter a position with this support that actually break, and actually we enter with this kind of resistance. So I think there is multiple indicators to go soon short. I prefer to wait here a confirmation, a candlestick confirmation here. Okay, actually the price is pushing up, so I want to wait something that can lead me to open a trade here. But still, we are in a zone that we should, that's a pair that we should have an eye on it, that we should be ready to maybe open a position. And we look here that also on the weekly, the price is very rich, we block it. On a daily, there is a lot of place to make here a lower row, for example. Okay. What's my criteria for confirmation? I get a lot of time this kind of questions, and here, like see on the H1, I will maybe show you a little kind of example. Okay, on the H4, for example, okay. If I were looking at the price before, let's say it was maybe on what day? It was actually on the 4th of October. Okay, I had this kind of candle view. Okay, the price switch and then starting to go down. Okay, so this kind of tricks here, like a doji, is a confirmation point. Okay, the price went down maybe 23 pips and then it make a test again. Okay, so there is multiple things for confirmation. There is the candlestick pattern. Okay, so here we have a doji. Here we have a very bearish candlestick as well. So you can also open a short position after the price starting to make a reaction. See, like just after this kind of move here. Also, it can be this kind of move here. So all the time you have to look at the candlestick to make an assumption. You see, like for example here. Can be also a confirmation need to go short, okay? Because the market is starting to make one doji, okay, and then a second one. So on the long term, it can be good to open maybe a small trade. So maybe that's what I will do here. I will open the world. That's a day trade, okay? Or even I can maybe hold this kind of trade for a few days or even a few weeks, okay? So it's not like a scalp that I want to show you here, but you know that's something we can look here. So let's open a sell position. Okay, I will try to put my stop loss just above this supply here that also the price can have a reaction. Okay, actually, I don't see the trade levels. Okay, perfect. Okay, so I will put my stop loss approximately above, okay, this kind of supply. Okay, and then I will wait maybe for here a break of this kind of low view. Okay. And I will be making, so it depends what kind of zone you're looking for that trade. Okay. It can be you can look for a take profit here on this demand. Okay, so that would be nice maybe to close it here, for example. Okay, or if you look at the daily, okay, for example, and then maybe you open a lower risk here, you can maybe hire, okay, for a lower low. Okay, actually, I don't want to be so greedy, so I will put here my demand. I actually opened the position on the H1 basis. So we'll have to wait for it. Okay, I think that also guy approximately in a break and retest zone. Okay, it can do the same here. It's actually the lowest point from previous day. Okay. So that's why I see confirmation. I see some reaction on the candlestick. Even I go here on the M5 and still the market is on an uptrend here, but I have candle this one touch, then a second touch. And still I have this supply here that can save me if the price started to push. I have another stop. I have another level that I can look for. Okay. So that's something I should hold. If I'm looking for a daily position, okay, for example, okay, I should put my stop loss above this level here, okay? Or even what, maybe just above this level, or can be also above to this supply, okay? So it maybe should be here, okay? And then the risk reward will be a bit lower, but it depends of what you're looking for risk here, okay? I offer the market on the H1 basis, so I believe that my stop loss was well put here, okay, approximately just above this supply. And then I will wait. Okay, you see here that the market is starting to make a great reaction here. Yeah, I believe that in M30 that's something I want to look for. And we will hold it. Okay. So that's why I took confirmation. You can also find some confirmation criteria regarding stochastics, okay, MACD, some RSI, some divergence. You can put many things. Okay, I also see that I use also Polygabon to see the volatility of the price. And I said that the price action approximately is on the moving average 20, approximately stands here. Okay. So generally, it's a good stop for the market to continue the trend. Okay, let's move on another pairs. We will be hold it until maybe the end of the day, on the end of the session, and wait if the take profit can be reached. Okay, the risky one here is very nice. I think that maybe it can be. It's a 20 pips stop loss trade to go for 100 pips. Okay, so it's 1 to 5, very hard to achieve, but that's something we can look for. Okay, and I will see how the price will react to this zone here. I will be comfortable with this kind of entry when the candlestick on the M15 or in the M30 will close. Okay, actually the candlestick didn't close, but if we close like that, okay, I think we are good to go. Okay, so that's the first thing. Let's talk about the Euro Australian, for example, right now. Breakout on the I'm time frame, I'm on sell. Okay. Okay, so I believe you are talking about this zone here on the daily chart. Okay. Okay, that's not bad. Okay, when I look at this kind of chart, actually the breakout is not confirmed for me, because when I look on the zone here, I'm not looking as a line. Okay, I'm looking for a zone. Okay, actually we are still in the zone. So when I'm waiting for breakout and retest, I'm waiting for this kind of break, very deep. Okay, then I wait for a small retracement, and then here I can open the sell. So it's exactly the same setup I had in the GBP USD. Let me see. Wait, put it aside. Okay, so it's approximately the same that we had on the daily chart. Okay, you see here that the market break very deep, then make a retest. So here can be maybe the entry. Okay, sometimes the market will not come back to that zone, so you cannot open that trade. But you want to have a great confirmation, and I believe that here on the Euro Australian pair, that you should still be waiting for a break. Okay, actually we still stand on the support. So we see on the H1 at the market, and we also in the H1. That the market touch one time, a second time, make a retracement. Still here, the market is on an uptrend. So be careful by having a sell here. If you open a sell here just before, let's say you open a sell on that zone, okay, that's nice. You can hold it. Okay, you should be ready, but you can hold it. But here for me, I don't find something to go short yet. Okay, you should be waiting for the breakout. Okay, and then you can see also on the H4 that we still stand here. There is no breakout yet. Okay, so that's why I'm waiting for the deep breakout and then the retracement. Okay, another pair that you want to review, guys. Actually, I would be very happy to open the buy position here, because we stand in a very strong demand zone and support and whatever. So maybe if I open your position, my stop loss will be like 25 pips on a daily basis, and I can hope for touching this kind of 100 pips target. Okay, so that will not be bad. Okay, that will not be bad at all to open here buy position. GBP USD, Nick, I just talked few times today about it. I will come back to this. Okay. So JVP USD H4. Here we are. Okay. This support react multiple times, breakout. Okay. You can see also on the daily. Okay. Actually, the market react 3 times here, then have a dip. Breakout, then we start the retest, and then today the market, I think today or yesterday, the market started the markets, and maybe remove this kind of trade here, what else? GBP and ZD. Okay. Okay, let's make the euro dollar before David is asking. I didn't make the euro dollar region yet. Starting it. On this. Okay, the euro dollar is very bearish. Okay, the dollar is starting to be stronger, and I believe, I think I talked about this maybe 1 week or 2 weeks ago when the market moved from risk on to risk off regarding the stock market. I'm not sure what's going on actually on the stock market in US, but if I see that the dollar is starting to gain some value, that's maybe going back from the stock market. Okay, so actually we break. And I think also the dollar index should be moving up, okay? If you are starting to see the dollar getting stronger. So actually on the daily or even on the weekly, we see that the market break this zone here, okay? So I believe that the market can have a bearish move, maybe to that zone here. I think that the next zone to see it will be this kind of zone. Okay. So I think that if you're already short, you can high them for this kind of zone here. So it will be 1.40. Okay. So this will be the zone. And then you can wait maybe for a small retracement to the retest we have. And then, open the sell position according to what's going on the stock market. And I'm looking here at the weekly. Okay. So that's why I can maybe take a bigger macro analysis to my strategy. If I go to the to something, if I go to a lower time frame, it's very difficult to make something here. The market is going down very deep. On the M1, we are starting. It's like a very small move here. I think we moved. It's like 20 pips retracement after a big breakout. So that's. I think that's how we see it. Okay, let's talk about the pound in New Zealand. Okay, interesting zone also in the daily here. This market, you see, this is something very volatile. Okay, you can be out with a tight stop loss very, very fast. Okay, but you see that this zone here, it's starting to make a retest. Actually, we make like a small fake breakout with this kind of big move. Still, the market on H4, it's still bullish. Okay, you see that all the time. You see all the time that the low is higher. Okay. But still on the daily, it's also stand on this level, but also stand on this supply zone. Okay, you see on the daily that this is a supply zone, for example. Okay, 1 minute. Okay, sorry for that. Okay. Okay, so that's how I see that. Here it's a big supply zone. That's why maybe the market make your eye move and then react. Okay. But still, I'm not sure when I see how many pips from, let's say, from here to here. It's a very volatile market. So if I don't know and I'm not sure about the trend of, or I'm not aware of this market, I prefer to be out. Okay. Actually, I'm not trading this market. But you should be very ready and you should have kind of some certain type of experience by trading this market. Okay, because the market is very volatile. Maybe on one day we can make like 300 pips up. It also can be a market when there is a lot of opportunities, but it can be the opposite. Okay, a lot of fake breakout, very volatile. So be ready for an exceeding of move. Okay, like here. Actually, it's react. You see that the supply zone is here, for example, but the market make something like that we have. So maybe if someone put the stop loss just here, it can be like out for a few pips, can be very frustrating. So if you are not sure, and if you are not some kind of backtest this market, or you don't have a strategy that works with high volatile market, you can try to be out for this kind of thing. David telling 1.12 is the area. Yeah, I think that's the area we should look for the euro dollar. Okay. I think on the weekly that this is the area actually. Okay, so far so good. What is CAD related to oil? Yeah, this is related to oil. The Canadian dollar is related because I think Canada most of its GDP making produce oil, something like that. So yeah, when oil is going up, the CAD is going down, for example. Okay, so that's how it works. You should be looking. That's why you should have an overview of what's going on in all the market. Okay, actually the oil is pushing above. I think it's the $80 on the WTI. Okay, so that's the barrel of New York. So when the market like that is pushing up, so you should be ready for a movement on the CAD. Okay, that's a very correlative market together. It's like the real Brazilian, the Brazil currency, and sugar, for example. Okay, like. In Brazil, the biggest production, Brazil is the biggest producer of sugar in the world. So that's why their currency is correlated to what's going on the sugar market and the opposite. What I can look from here? Let's go back to the trade I opened. I think you see very, very nice. Here it's a confirmation. Okay, so if you wait for the M15. So we have this kind of confirmation, and we have also this stochastic that is coming above just here. Okay. So you see, you can have your own confirmation biases, not biases, but on real confirmation to open the trade here. Okay, actually, I think that maybe I can remove my stop loss maybe above this low, this high move. I believe that we can break on the M5. You see that on the M5. The price is still on an uptrend. Okay, for example, we actually just stand on it. If we make here the lower low, okay, I will definitely remove my stop loss to the break-even, for example. Let's say the market reach this kind of level here. I will this kind of level, yeah, I will remove my stop loss to the break-even. Okay, so let's wait for a deeper move. I want to look what's going on also on the stock market. I believe that is the dollar actually is doing well, so let me check if someone also is looking to that market. I think we live in all what everything is correlated together. So you have to put an eye on what's going on the stock market and everything. Looks good. How to trade, Stefan? You are maybe talking about this trade here. I think I can trade my stop loss. Okay, it depends. If here, okay, the move is continuing below this kind of zone here, I see that there is a very important zone. Okay, it's like the market structure. Okay, so big move, the market structure starting consolidation move and then moving up. So I believe that this zone, like let's say the beginning of this zone, is approximately here. So I should be careful when the market is starting here. I can maybe close a partial profit to that zone. But you see that if you break this kind of zone here, the market can go 50 pips below. Okay, you see that here there will be no buy at all. Okay, there is no zone here. So that's a good zone to see. Yeah, the market is doing very nice here. I hope we can make here our low. What's doing on the S&P? A bit flat, okay, 1% below, down 1%. Okay, let's talk about the Australian yen here. I think we are good so far. Okay. Okay. So we have this zone so far, okay? When we make a break to that lowest point, make a retest here, then still make a retest here. So that's a zone where you should look at. Okay, you see here it's sort kind of beginning of an uptrend because the low is higher. Okay, with this kind of move. Okay, so I believe we should look for a continuation of that trend. Maybe the market can also become less volatile and enter this kind of a triangle. Okay, that's something we can expect on a daily basis, for example. I think when you see this kind of market here, if you look at this kind, if you look at this kind of structure here, you can maybe develop a strategy for a special type of a market structure. Here we are actually in the middle of, let's say, nowhere. There was a supply here, but still, you see that the market is reacting. You don't know where the market's going. The market don't know where we'll go. It's like ups and down. And if you go to the H1, you see that the market will retest multiple times. Okay, so here you see that maybe we can make a bigger screen here. Okay, so the market make a first stop here, then it's react to this kind of thing. Then also here, you see that the market is actually on a wedge. Okay, trading on a wedge, react also to this supply. The first supply was here, then the second step was just here. Actually, I'm kind of in the middle of nowhere in the H1. Maybe the only thing I can see in the M30 is there is on the M30 a daily support that you should look at. Okay, so that's the zone you have to look at on the M30. Okay, on the 80.55 level approximately. Okay, you see that the market, if you're a day trader, this kind of market is for you. Okay, you look, okay, we react one time, second time, third time, the first time. Also, here you can maybe look for this retest here. And then the market react today. Okay, so you can buy and sell all the time in the market. If you feel on a strategy, you should be aware of what is the market future and where the market stands. Actually, we are in a consolidation zone. And you know, you can play with that. And when the market is going here, you can sell the market and so on. Okay, actually, there is no trend on that market. So that's how you can put an edge and have an edge on in this kind of market. Also here, the confirmation will be this kind of stochastics here that approximately go below 20 or 10. Okay, so it's also another confirmation. And if I think at the beginning of the session, someone was asking, Enrique was asking, what is your criteria for confirmation? So here is another example for confirmation. I have my stochastics here that is below. Everyone will have his own indicator here. I have this first. Okay, candle here. I think it's called a hammer. I'm not sure, but you see first weeks here, then the second one. So when the market started to consolidate, okay, it's maybe the beginning of a new move, of a new movement. Okay, so that's how I see actually this market here. Let's say the next zone for a sale here will be on the M15, maybe this zone. Okay. Yeah, it can be this zone. Okay, it will be this supply, and it will be also this kind of support that can become a resistance in the M15. Okay, and also there is the highest point, but I'm not sure you'll reach it today. So that's the point on the Australian yen. Any other pair, guys, that you want to check? Maybe we didn't talk about the yen, okay? Your cut. Okay, let's talk about your cut. You see that in the GBP USD, yet the uptrend is still a bit here, okay, on the M5. Look, for a small scalper, it could be nice to enter as well. Okay. I wanted at the beginning to open some scalping, but you see, you have this zone on the M1. We have also this stochastic here that is very here. Okay, actually, it is the opening of the New York trading session. I think it's I think 2:30 in UK. Yeah, so here can be a beginning of a long, for example. There is tight stop loss. Okay, so an example. I will still hold my partial position because it's a long term, not long term, but few hours, even few days position. So I will not be opening a long view. Okay. Okay, I have many questions here, so I will start with the Euro CAD. Euro CAD is very interesting. Okay, I think the market is moving because of the oil, so you should be looking at the oil when looking at the CAD. So that's the first advice I can be giving to you. And you see that here on the CAD, the market started to break, okay, this kind of strong support here. So I believe that the market can still go down according to oil, depends of what oil will doing, of what oil will do. And you see also still can expect a retracement, can expect here, don't move here, for example. Okay. So that's all I see on the daily. There is the market went down very fast. There was also this zone here, for example. Very consolidation zone, very range on a daily basis. How many pips the market went down here? It's like 400 pips straight away. Okay, so when the if the market break this kind of resistance, there will be a sort kind of inflection point. The market, I believe, will be test this zone. It shouldn't be should be like that. And if I go to the H4, you see like there is nothing to make a buy here yet. No confirmation at all. The market is only going down. The H1 is the same. So if you find an opportunity to open a sell position, okay, you can look for it. But making a buy here would be very difficult, actually. And you see that the pendulum just make the reaction on this point here. Okay, that's also a spot I could trade as a scalper here, for example. Okay, very interesting. All right, the New Zealand dollar, for example, let's look at it. Maggie is asking. Okay, I still think we stand in the support zone. Okay, there was here a fake breakout, then the price recovered very fast. But I still believe here we can find a buying opportunity. Okay. And also when I see this kind of low here and then here an higher low, for example, okay, with this kind of trend line, it's nice maybe to open this kind. You can open it here, for example, in this position on the H4 basis. Okay. I believe that here it's the inflection point. Okay, just to, that should be nice. What's going on the H1? Also, great reaction on this trend line, for example. You have also the stochastic that just crossed, let's say, 2 hours before. So I think we can see the biggest move here. Okay, maybe to the median of the Bollinger Bands, just here, to that supply. Okay, we said that there will be a supply on the H1, there will be this supply. Okay, so that will be the last target to check, and the first target for the buying position will be this kind of target here. Yeah, so that's how I see the market. Okay, it's very achievable to go here. And still, if you're a very aggressive trader for a break and retest and you know the market suits you perfectly, okay, there is this level to open a short, for example. Okay, you have this support, this daily support that I think today we break it. Actually, we are turning, we can see a small retest here. Okay, so be ready for a retest, for example. Okay, you can, there was a deep move we can make. Can reach this zone. Wait for a small confirmation, candlestick confirmation, whatever you need, and then maybe open a sell position for a day trade. Okay. But still, if you look at the H4 and the H1, I believe we can see here an eye move. That's for the New Zealand. What percent risk you recommend your trade for intraday? Okay, if you're talking about a Fiverr's account, you know that in the Fiverr's account, the drawdown is 4%. Okay, so when you know that the drawdown is 4%, it depends on how you feel comfortable in the market, but I believe that between 0.3% or like between 0.3% and 0.5% should be the risk you should allocate for each trade you open. Okay. Therefore, if you have some consecutive trades in a row that that are loss trades, you will still be alive by risking 0.3% or 0.5%. Okay, so that's how you can allocate the risk. Australia, New Zealand. Since we talked about it today, I'm not sure. This also was this also is very interesting. Okay, you see here on the weekly, we are actually entering this zone. Okay, that wire support. Okay, we act also here with this week's, you see, breakout. We start to retest. Okay, you should maybe be waiting for a consolidation here. You see that the market make a retracement top over how many pips this is. That's approximately 100 pips. Okay, and if you see here a confirmation, you can open a short position for a very long time. Okay, maybe you can go to that zone or even to that zone. Okay, so it will be. Yeah, let me show you. Let's open something. Okay. It will be the zone you're looking for. But still, you should be waiting for a confirmation here. The market is very bullish recently. You see on the daily that we had this very long trend line. Okay. There's a big pressure, and then the price actually break this kind of trend line. So you should be careful. And still, I think today the market starting. Oh, okay. Here also you see that there was this supply that actually created. I think we are starting to see a small reaction to that zone. Okay. So on the HY, I think that's what you should look for. Okay, if you have a confirmation to go short here, the stop loss can be approximately below, sorry, above this supply zone. So it will be, I don't know, let's say you open the short position here, the stop loss may be approximately 50 pips above. And the take profit should be at least 50 pips, or we can IM to the can objective the lowest point with 200 pips, risk reward 1 to 4. Okay, so that's gonna be a nice, that would be a nice indication. But wait for a confirmation here. Here on the H1, you see stochastics starting to cross over. Yeah, you're in an overbuy scenario. The euro dollar, we go back to the euro dollar. think before I go back to the euro dollar, I will go to the yen. I think we didn't talk about the yen yet. And then I will finish with the euro dollar. Let's say the dollar yen. Okay, interesting. Oh, okay, there might be a nice spot for swing trades. Okay, you have this resistance zone here that reacts multiple times. It is a very strong zone. And then you go to the daily, the market started to make a small reaction, started a bit retracement, and again today we are a bit, we are starting to go down. Okay, I think it can be a zone to open a short trade for a few days. Okay, I think you can eye them for. I think the best zone to eye them, of course, it will be that zone. Yes, it will be 200 pips approximately, and also you can eye them for the second zone will be approximately to that zone. That was on the H4. You will see a strong resistance zone. So I believe you can. Is a kind of a double top. Okay. Okay, let's finish with the euro dollar today. I hope you enjoyed the content today. Was I think very nice. There was a big nice. There was a lot of opportunities actually going on. We are approaching a weekly support and resistance in a few pairs, so you can open a swing trade. Trades and hold it for a few times. Okay, so the order, I think I told it in the middle of the session. We actually brought this kind of support here on the weekly chart, so I believe we can see a lower move to that zone. I'm not telling that you should open the short position here, okay? Because I think the market, the train already moved, okay? So you should be a formal trader, okay? You should be waiting for a reaction of the market. So I believe here the market can go down to this kind of zone here, okay? It will be maybe approximately just above this zone. Okay, it will be this zone here, okay? And then wait for a small retest, small retracement, and then maybe look what's going on here and maybe opening with a position. Okay, so that's why I see the euro dollar. Okay. I will finish by the pound dollar. Okay, that's a trade I opened in one decision. You see that in M1. The market make a good reaction. You see, in here I can open a sell position, for example. Okay, so let's say I can maybe reinforce my strategy here. Okay, I can open another sell position, put my stop loss at the same point. I will just explain why after I'm trading. Meanwhile, the market is moving here. Okay. So I have this zone. Okay, that was an M1 kind of work, and then we break and actually we make a retest. Actually, the stochastics is starting to cross here. Okay, so I believe the market can go down. In M1 and in M5, we are a bit in consolidation zone. So I increase the risk because I feel comfortable with it. Okay, my stop loss is above this zone. I think I can maybe close this kind of trade on the first touch. Okay, approximately to that zone. Okay, that will be my TP1 and then my TP2 for the swing trade. Okay. Any other question, guys? Okay, last question before I close the session today. No? Okay. Okay, guys, it was a nice session. Thank you for staying with me. It was the last training room for this week. So we will meet, I believe, Monday for the weekly forecast. I'm not sure who will be doing the session. So have a nice days. Have a nice training day as well. Still, stick to the training plan is the most important thing. Manage your risk. You can learn in one good process. Thank you, guys, everyone. Thank you, Nick. Thank you, Stefan, John, Conrad, David, Enrique, Shabbat. Thank you, everyone. Bye-bye.